kindness, wide graces on these your servants, Mama and Papa, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, I please ask you to be seated. If we can have our readers please come forward and have our first reader.
Hospitality, for through it some have unknowingly entertained angels. Be mindful of prisoners. sharing their imprisonment, and of the ill-treated as of yourselves, free also are in the body. Let marriage be honored among all, and the marriage bed be kept undefiled. Let your life be free from the love of money, but be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never forsake you or abandon you. Thus, we may say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, and I will not be afraid. The word of the Lord.
He did not have to create us. He still would have existed even if we didn't exist.
chose to create us because his love goes out. He doesn't keep it for himself. And the love that flows from God into us is meant to go out into other people. We don't just keep God's love for ourselves. We have to share it and make sure it pours out to other people. That same love, that same exact love that comes from God, is present today in Dawn and Kyle. And it is a particular love that God has destined from the beginning of creation. And when we look at ourselves and our lives and how things happen, and how we're always amazed how things kind of fit together, they fit together because God put them together. He destined, for whatever reason, from the beginning of time, that Dawn and Kyle would find each other. Out of 7 billion people, Dawn and Kyle found each other. It wasn't happenstance, it wasn't by accident, it was divine law, and it was divine love from God that allowed that to happen. And out of the 7 billion people, they're going to spend their lives together. They're going to grow together. They're going to have weaknesses. They're going to have strengths. They're going to have joys. They're going to have sorrows. But all of those are going to be had together. In our gospel, we see that from the beginning of time, God made them male and female. And he made them male and female with the purpose of being together. Just like magnets come together, just like two pieces of metal can be fused together to create a bigger structure. He brought them together. They weren't created to be separated. They were meant to be joined. And the love of God, and that love that God has, will be used in Dawn and Kyle's lives to, God willing, support a family. And even to a bigger extent, that love that they share will help support society. Because it's not buildings that support society, it's not money, it's not anything else. It's family, it's coming together, it's two different people coming together for the sake of love. That's what binds a society together. When we look and see the family structure, when we look and see how two people can love each other in the midst of hate, in the midst of violence, how two people can come together and love each other so much that they're willing to spend the rest of their lives together. So as we gather today to celebrate this holy union between Dawn and Kyle, we pray for their marriage. We pray that it will be blessed with the love of Jesus Christ. And may their marriage serve as a beacon of hope to the rest of the world in dark times. And may God bless this holy union between Dawn and Kyle. And what God has joined together, may no man separate. At this time, we invite the wedding party up and the bride and groom so that we can have an exchange with the guys. My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and his community. Christ abundantly blessed this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage, mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Dawn and Kyle, have you come here freely without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your life?
Yes.
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hand and declare your consent before God and His church. I, God, take you, to be my mother. I promise to be true to you, in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord and His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. For God has sworn and man has not lied. May the Lord bless these words. She gives to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. Amen. God take this ring, as a sign of my love, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and of the Holy Spirit. God take this ring. Now that we have just witnessed the marital bond between Dom and Kyle, we now pray for them with the intercessions. The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church throughout the world, may our faith in the love God has for us been expressed in our love for one another, be now and forever. We pray to the Lord. For peace in our world, may all men who suffer violence and injustice find peace and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord. For the poor, the homeless, and for those who are unemployed, may our care and concern for those in need be a sign of God's love. We pray to the Lord. For the protection and sanctity of human life from conception until natural death, may all people be treated with dignity they deserve as God's children. We pray to the Lord. For all those preparing for the sacrament of marriage, may they grow in wisdom and grace and see their vocation to married love as a sign of God's love. We pray to the Lord. For Dom and Kyle, begin their married life together this day. May they experience the love of God, the support of family and friends, and the blessings of children. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of Dom and Kyle, and from all present in this wedding, may they enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment and eternal life. We pray to the Lord. Let us humbly invoke by our prayers your brothers and sisters, God's blessing upon the bride and groom, that in his kindness he may favor with himself those on whom he has bestowed the sacrament of matrimony. Holy Father, Maker of the whole world,
and created man and woman in your own image, and will that their union be crowned with your blessing. We humbly beseech you, with these your servants, who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your loving blessing, Lord, be down upon this bride of God and upon God and the man of God. May the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that they unite together the gift of matrimony. They may adorn their family with children and nurse the church. In happiness, may they praise you, Lord, in sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know that you are near. Comfort them in need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly, bear witness to you in the law, that after a happy old age, together with several friends and surrounding them, and they come to the kingdom of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
May God the eternal Father keep you of one heart and love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day